here, no, we have to find out what is the expected utility. How do we find out expected utility here, students? To find out expected utility, we have to combine the probability with the utility value. Okay. So what are the probabilities here? 0.2 into 0.7. Probability values are less than 1. So 0.2, 0.7, 0.1. These are the probability values. These values should be combined with the utility values. What are the utility values for S1, S2, S3? So for every state, some value will be assigned. That is called utility value here. So 100, 50, 70 are the utility values. Now we are combining this probability and utility by using this equation. What is this equation? It is sum of the probability into the utility for every outcome. Okay. So how many outcomes here we have? By performing action A1, we are getting 3 outcomes, students. By performing action A1, we are getting 3 outcomes. So for every outcome, we have to add these products. Okay. So that we are getting what expected utility for the given action. Okay. So, what is the expected utility for action A1 is 62. Like that, using this equation, we will be finding what is the expected utility for each and every action on the given state. Now, what is the principle of maximum expected utility? The maximum expected utility principle is that the agent has to choose an action that will maximize the agent's expected utility. Okay. So, for example, you see here, students, there are 2 actions, A1 and A2. These are the 2 actions that can be performed on the state S1. Okay. Now, agent has to take the decisions which action to be considered. Okay. So, which action to be considered here? Which action gives the maximum expected utility, that action will be considered. Okay. So, just now we have discussed how to find out the utility value, no? Expected utility, that we have to combine the utility with the outcome probability. So for A1, what is the action A, for action A1, what is the utility value is 62. Similarly, for action A2, what is the utility value? That is 0.7 into 50 plus, okay. So for this action, what is the utility value here is 0.2 into 50. Plus 0.8 into 80. Okay, if you know this, what is the value we got? 74. Okay, now agent will be taking the decisions which action to be considered based on these utility values. So, which is having maximum value? So, action A2 is having maximum value, no? So, this agent will perform action A2. Okay, that is called principle of maximum expected utility. What is the principle of maximum expected utility is that the agent will choose an action which is giving the maximum expected utility. Okay. So, what is this maximum expected principle defined that right action to take in any decision problem. If there is any decision problem, which decision to be considered? So, in this maximum expected utility will give us the right action. Okay. So what is here? The computations can be prohibited. So these computations cannot be reduced. Okay. It is sometimes difficult even to formulate the problem completely. These are the P2 issues it is having. What is the first issue here is the computations involved can be prohibited. Okay. This is the first issue. Sometimes it is even difficult to formulate the problem completely. These are the 2 issues we will be having. Okay. So, for this first, we have to know the initial state. See here, from which state it is starting. So, we have to know the initial state. Okay. To know the initial state, the world requires, means the environment requires, what are the things it requires? It requires perception, learning, knowledge representation, and these are the things it requires to know the initial state. Okay, it has to learn complete every time from the environment. It has to need to receive information about the state of the environment. That is what perception. Okay, it has need to know the state of the environment and it has to learn from the environment. So whatever it is learning from, whatever it is learning from that, it should get some knowledge. Okay, so that is called knowledge, and it is able to find the inference. Okay, based on this, it is able to get the initial state of the environment. Okay, so here we have discussed that we have to compute what is the probability of outcome for every action given the evidences. Okay, so this term is required every time to find out what is the maximum expected utility, yes or no. So computing this value requires what? The causal model of the environment, and it is also requires the non-deterministic polynomial or inference in the Bayesian network. Okay, it requires the Bayesian network and causal model. Causal model means what? The Bayesian, we have discussed, no? That Markov process. That Markov process is called causal model. Okay. So it requires the causal model and the Bayesian networks to compute this probability of outcome for every action and the given the evidences. Okay. So we also discussed that the computing the utility of each state. Okay, we have to find out what is the utility of each state requires what? Searching or planning. You cannot simply assign, the agent cannot simply assign some value to each and every state. It has to search and plan properly to assign the each and every action. Otherwise, what happens? It will start with some problem. Okay, so that is why whenever some value is assigned to each and every state, the agent has to do searching and planning properly. Okay, and because the agent does not know how good a state, okay, whenever it is reaching a state by performing some action, what happens here, student? By performing some action, it will be reaching any one of the state. Okay, whenever it is reaching particular state, it has to know whether that is a good state or not. What is good state? Good state is a state that leads to the solution. Okay, so if the state it is reaching is not reaching the solution, that is not leading to solution, what is that? It is not a good state. Okay, so by performing some action, it is reaching the good state or not, it should know it. Okay, how it will be knowing that? It should know. Has to know from which state it is reaching that particular state. So whenever it is reaching to S1 from S0, okay, compared to S0, S1 should have the good values, means the improvement, there should be some improvement in S1 compared to S0, okay. So for example, if you are taking some other state S2, so the utility value of S2 is less than S1, S0, then it is not reaching the good state, because from the better state, it is reaching the low state. Okay, so it should calculate every time the to which state it is reaching and from which state it is going to the particular state. Okay, it has to completely measure that. Okay, so here Bayesian theory, we are going to discuss here is Bayesian theory is not a solution to solve AA problem. It is a not solution to solve all AA problems, but it will give you the framework into which we can see where all components of AA system fit. Okay, it will give you the complete framework how these systems of AA will be fit into that theory. Okay, so that it is going to give the solution, but it does not, it may or may not give the solution to all the problems, AA problems, but what is that here? It is able to give you the framework. Okay, so whenever you will be asking some solution for the some problem to address, what they will give you some ideas, the framework. Okay, so like that, the Bayesian theory gives some framework so that all the systems of AA will fit properly. Okay, all the components in the AA system will fit properly. Okay, so before discussing the Bayesian theory, we will be discussing what is utility theory. What are the basis of utility theory? Here we are going to discuss three topics students, that is constraints on benchmark performance, preferences, axioms of utility theory, and utility. These are the three terms we are going to discuss.